The name of our Lord and it is my prayer that you are well wherever you're watching us from. Welcome to this live broadcast program from Buruburu Community Center Church of God. And today it is my prayer that we will have a wonderful time in the presence of the Lord. And before I get into my to encourage us that God has given us a very wonderful opportunity that we can have church through this virtual space. A space that it has created so that we may reach you in the comfort of your homes. And feel like Jesus even as we start our time together and even as we fellowship together service. My name is Pastor Jairus Webuye. I am a pastor by call. I am a reverend by ordination. And I am a child of God by calling. And I would like to just tell you that this particular day I want to preach a short message entitled Divine Connection Between the Ear, the Mouth and the Eye. The thing that you hear is important, and the things that you speak are important, and the things that you also see are important. And I will get my short message from the book of Matthew chapter 20, and I'll read from verse 29 to 34. Then I will speak. Let me Bible say that Jesus and his disciples Jericho. A large crowd followed him and was sitting by the roadside. And when they heard that Jesus was going by, they shouted, "Lord, Son of David, have mercy on us." The crowd rebuked them and told them to be quiet. But they shouted all the louder, "Son, Lord, Son of David, have mercy on us." Jesus stopped and called them. "What do you want me to do for you?" he asked. "Lord," they answered, "we want our sight back." Jesus said, and Jesus had compassion on them and touched their eyes. Immediately they received their sight and followed him. This is a very and of course you see Jesus Christ and Jericho, and the story is about Jesus now getting and of course we know the story. This story also. When you read, I believe it is Mark chapter 10, I believe it is verse either 36 or 46, there's a place where that same scripture is amplified, and also Luke also brings out the same story. And there's something that is so interesting is that each and every writer who wrote this story, because when you look at the proceedings, you see Jesus coming from Jericho going to Jerusalem. And so it is reasonable to assume that the three authors were speaking about the same story that I have read from the book of Matthew, chapter 20. And there are certain things that I want to bring out, things that we need to realize as believers and as children of the household of faith. And one of the things is that there are things that we can see. One is that Jesus is moving from Jericho and getting into Jerusalem. And of course, when you read the Bible, this is, I think, at a place where Jesus, when he was talking about the parable of the person who was attacked by robbers, I think this is the same part that particular parable was also talking about. And when you look at the place where Jesus was walking, it was not a very safe place. And the good thing, when you read that particular passage, the Bible talks about as Jesus was moving with his disciples, the Bible talks about a crowd following Jesus. And there is something about a crowd, but today I will not delve deep into the issue of crowd. But there are a few things that you can realize about crowd. And this particular crowd, for the crowd to follow Jesus, one, followed him because of the things that they had seen, hence gotten persuaded out of the makeup and the character and the things that Jesus and who Jesus was. And the second thing about a crowd, the other people who could be in that particular crowd who might have followed Jesus based on the miracles that he performed and not exactly out of the person that Jesus was.
And the third category of people that we can see in a crowd, we see in a crowd people who are part of the crowd, but they are really in that particular crowd out of their own personal interest and the gains that they stand to gain. And there are certain things that you will see out of that particular passage, I think that the Bible is talking about. And the Bible talks about when these particular people were walking, it brings now a picture of two blind men. When you read in the book of Mark, Mark talks about one blind person. And Mark has a name of that person, and he calls that particular person Bartimaeus. When you look at Luke also talks about a blind person who was healed by Jesus on his way from Jericho to Jerusalem. But Luke does not have a name of this particular person. And the gospel according to Matthew brings about now two blind people. And Matthew does not even have a name of these two people. And there are certain things that we need to understand. When Matthew is bringing about the story of the two blind men who are seated by the roadside, Matthew also does not have a name, but basically it takes time to define them based on the problem that they were going through, based on the condition that they had, the condition of blindness. And many a times, you know, people, even as you move in, that many a times they are placed at a state of blindness. The things that you are trusting God for, you are blind and you cannot see them clearly. That you have prayed over an issue for a long time, but still no answer has been forthcoming. And the good thing about these three people, these two blind men, they stayed put. And the message connection between the ears, the mouth, and the eyes, there are certain things that you need to realize. One, and I'll bring a few things out of the passage of scripture that I have read. The Bible tells that two blind men were sitting by the roadside. One particular thing that you need to realize is that positioning is important. That you know, God many a times will find you at a certain location to be, and there are certain specific places that God wants us to operate under. And when God sends his angels, maybe with a package of answer to your prayers, location, and then location and position is important. The Bible talks about these people were stayed put at a place, I think it was by design, at a certain place where their miracle came and located them. Then the Bible, when you look at the Bible talks about, and this is the first thing that I want to mention on. It says that as they were seated by the roadside at a certain position, the Bible says that when they heard that Jesus was going by, they shouted. When they heard. There is something about the things that we hear. Let me tell you, brothers and sisters, the first thing that happened to them is that they heard that Jesus was going to pass by. And there is something important about the things that we listen, that we hear, the things that we give and subject our ears to, brothers and sisters. It is very important when we come and yield our ears to certain things that are inclined in accordance to the will of God. And many a times when we read Romans chapter 10 verse 17, the Bible says that faith cometh and hear by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And let me tell you, when you give your ears to something that is positive, let me tell you, a miracle will be sure, and your miracle is on the way. It doesn't matter how long you have waited for your miracle. The thing that you need to do is that when you stay put at a certain position, that Jesus and God will come and locate you in, your miracle is good and it will come to a place of happening. And so these particular people, as they were stayed put on that location, the first thing that the Bible talks about is that they heard that Jesus Christ was passing by. And let me tell, COVID disease, the COVID pandemic, it has devastated the whole world. And one of the things that is happening is that it has brought people to a place of panic and to a place of fear. And not many people are sure tomorrow. But let me tell you, I've come here to tell you today that it doesn't matter if you're on the right, then begin yielding your ears to the right and begin listening to the right thing. There's so many information. There is so much communication about things that are happening around us concerning this particular pandemic. But one of the things that I like to tell you, that in as much there is news that is being casted out that is releasing a lot of fear. We need to control and take authority over the things that we allow our ears to hear. Like will be that may we come and yield our ears more to the word of God. May we come and yield our ears more to the things that God is doing. May we come and yield our ears more to the things that God will want us to do. What are we hearing? What are the things that we are hearing? What are we listening to? At this particular time, may the gospel be amplified. May the gospel be the thing that will give us a... The second thing that the Bible talks about is that even as these particular people were there, stayed at a certain position, listening to the things that God would want them to listen to, there's another thing that I want us to discover. There's another thing that I want. The second thing is that they shouted. There is something about speaking. There is something about the things that we declare. There is something about a thing and it shall be established. That life and death lies in the power of the tongue. That whatever you speak, your belly shall be filled. And let me tell you, one of the is not just yield our ears to the things that we are supposed to hear, but we are supposed to also yield our mouth so that our mouth will also cooperate and speak it. The Bible says that out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. And every time when the mouth speaks out of the abundance of the heart, it is basically composed by the things that we have heard all through the word of God, because the entrance of the word of the Lord, it bringeth light. And let me tell you, when you're illuminated, when you're full of the word of God, and even upon your heart, that it is the word of God that has filled you, when you begin speaking the things that have filled you, every time when you speak the word, you are speaking faith. Because faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And let me tell you, the currency, as every nation has. Kenya, we have the Kenya shilling. Uganda, they have the Uganda shilling. If you go to Sweden, it's the Swedish krona. If you go to Germany, it's a Deutschmark. If you go to America, it is American dollar. If you go to Europe or Britain, it is a sterling pound. And as every other country has a currency that can achieve natural. In the spiritual faith and the currency in this kingdom of God and the currency in Christianity, it is a currency of faith. Faith can buy. Faith has power to purchase. Faith has power that whatever you desire, faith has. And this faith cometh by, and when that particular word of God, then we begin speaking it, that becomes faith. It becomes creative power. It becomes the two things. You know, power, there's a word in Greek, it's called dunamis. Dunamis is explosive power. That every time when you speak, dunamis power, explosive power. That the things that are stubborn, they break into pieces based on dunamis power. Then there is another word called megatos, also in Hebrews. Megatos basically means vast power. That this power that we speak, it is explosive. That the power that we speak, every time that we are talking about, it is also distributed. It is also vast. And that is one thing that we need to realize. That indeed, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And out of the abundance, when you are filled with the word of God, when we speak, it becomes. You know, in Genesis chapter 1, when God was creating, what God did, he used the power of the word to create. God said, and there was. God said, and he looked at what he had said and called into being. God looked and he was satisfied, and he said that it is good. And we need to realize the power of the divine connection between the eye, the mouth, and the eyes. And let me tell you, when we come now to the third. Uh, And even as we speak, we need to declare. We declare they come into being after you have realized that every time when you speak things by faith, they come into being. And so we need to be very careful as believers that whatever we speak, we need to be very careful that we are not speaking negative things, but we are speaking things. So whatever decree, it shall be established. And you need to be very careful not to decree negative things, but to decree positive things. And now the third thing that I want us to talk about is now the eyes. You know, most of us, we need to really desire to be at a place where things are answered, where the prayer that you have made will to the prayers that we made. Most of us will be desired. Let me tell you, every time when you pray and you see the result of the things that you pray for, it gives you pleasure. It gives you pleasure. It gives you confidence. It gives you joy. And it encourages you to even keep on praying and praying and praying. And the two beggars, one of the things that they did, they heard that Jesus was passing by. The second thing is that they cried and they called, "Oh, Jesus, son of David." I'm sure it was based on the things that they have heard about Jesus. They have heard about Jesus as a miracle worker. They have heard about Jesus, of the things that he had performed. And they also knew him as a Messiah. Because when you look at that particular one, "Jesus, son of David," it shows that they were already submitted under that messianic order. That they realize that this is the true Messiah. They realize that this is the true Lord. They realize that this is the person of the order of David that has been prophesied forth by the long-term prophet that Jesus had. The Bible talks about the crowd coming and trying to protect them. And many a times we find ourselves so excited about crowds. But let me tell you, when you look at times, crowds can be a hindrance. But many a times, crowds also can be a resource. Crowds can be an asset. And then one of the things, where every time when Jesus looked at a crowd, he did not just see a multitude, but he was looking at a crowd, but identifying individuals within the crowd. And the Bible says that when these blind men came towards Jesus, and yearning for their miracle, and they wanted Jesus to do a miracle for them. And one of the things that for you to get a miracle, you need to be desperate in your heart. You need to be desirous in your heart. You need to be yearning. You need to be totally sold out. And so when they came and they cried, the Bible says that the crowd tried to protect them. But let me tell you, over something, you will not allow yourself to be detoured. You will not allow yourself to be blocked. You will keep on pressing forth. You will keep on raising your voice and shouting and calling to happen. And the Bible says that these people, when the crowd came and they wanted to block them, that they may not receive their miracle, the Bible says that they shouted even the louder. And I pray that maybe there's somebody, you have been at a situation, at a depressing state, that things are not working out well, and you have shouted, and there are certain obstacles that are blocking you that you may not receive your miracle. And obstacles that are blocking you that you may not press forth. My encouragement for all of us is that we need to keep on pressing on. We need to keep on pressing on. We need to keep on pressing on until we receive our miracle, until our miracle is full, until God gives us a breakthrough. And this is what these two blind men did. As the people, the Bible says that they shouted even the louder until they got the attention of the master. And the master, when the crowd tried to block them, the master said, "Bring them over." I pray that during this season, that the master will say, "Bring them over." In the blindness that we've had over a long time, you know, there are so many people who are physicalized, but they're spiritually blind. That in that particular blindness, may God call us closer to him. Even the thing we have desired to see, may God call us closer to him for our miracle. That even as we keep on pressing, even as we keep on pressing. My prayer for all of us is that we may come to a place of getting the attention of the Master. Get his full attention and his that come. Something that is so interesting. Of course, there are things that we need to. They heard and they shouted and they called. Now the third thing, Jesus comes to them and he asks them, what are you wanting to do for you? That's an open take. That everything that he will say, they were those two blind men, I would have told Jesus. Though I went forth and told him many other things that I will desire him to do, face to face with the Messiah. And so when there are certain things that you need to do. You need to bring all that we lack because we do not ask. I tell you, these people asked for sight. They, of course, they were given sight. Thing or the other things are not well. I for them, and so they. Jesus asked them, what do you want me? That the thing that had pressed them for a long time, oh, we want it lifted. We want it to be taken away. We want it to be rolled away. And so the Bible says that then Jesus, and he said that receive your sight. When you read the message according to Luke, the Bible says that, that thy faith has made you well. Even Mark speaks the same. Made you well. The faith that I say that you need to hear, because faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the word of God, then it drops into our hearts and becomes a conviction. And out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks to the mouth. And immediately everything that you speak, it becomes alive, intangible. And the two blind men, their eyesight was restored. And they looked, and there was joy in that particular area. The third issue about seeing. When the Bible says that may our eyes be continually stayed on Jesus, who is the author and finisher of through hearing and hearing by the word of God. May our eyes be stayed, that even as we are being faced with the tough times around us, even as we are facing things that we do not understand and hearing stories, living at a time we are being faced with things that we could not imagine we could face them during our time, and these particular things are here, and a lot of things are happening. And this particular morning, my encouragement for all of us is that may we use the senses that God has given us, may we use the divine organs that God has given unto us, that whatever we listen to, let it be of God, let it be God. Let it be of God, let it be godly. And ultimately, after we hear and we speak godly, after we do all that, let me tell you, we will see. And when you see God, you will marvel. Because in God, there are many facets. And God is filled with goodness. And that is my encouragement for us this particular day. We come to a place of staying put, being at a place where God has called us to be. Even if we are not coming to church every Sunday, we let the presence of the Lord be continually in our heart. Let us continue rejoicing in God. That of course Sunday, the physical church, we cannot meet. Even as we address this particular thing, is for a short season. I pray that once the congregation gets opened, that we will be more joyous to meet, and we will celebrate and appreciate each other's company, even as we encourage ourselves in the Lord, even as we inspire each other and speak positive things to each other, and speak positive things about each other, and prophesy and declare the word of God. And let me tell you, God will do the things that we have desired over a long period of time. How are we using our ears? What have we yielded our ears to? How are we using our mouth? Are we yielding our mouths to? How are we yielding our eyes? What have we yielded our eyes to? Because it is important. What we hear is important. What we speak is important. And what we see, because what we hear and what we speak will ultimately affect what we see. So if that is what will fill your heart, and that is what will bubble out, and you will see negativity become a product of negativity. But if you fill yourself with positivity, that is what, and that is what you will speak, and that is what you will become. Positive confessor. Positive people. Speaking positivity, where we are confessing positivity, we are creating and speaking victory, we are creating love, we are speaking joy, we are speaking peace, we are speaking goodness, we are speaking the lifting of the Lord. And so my desire for all of us as children of God is that God, just like the two blind men, that we will get the attention of Jesus, and that he will come and meet our every need. But some of the things that we need to do, we need to hear, we need to speak, then we will see. It is. And Revelation, lastly, Revelation, I believe it is 1:7, it says that let each and every person who has ears hear what the Spirit of God is telling. He that has ears, let him hear what the Spirit of God is telling the church. Because during this season, God is speaking, and he's speaking loudly. But it is just that our ears at times get seared. The way Job said in Job 33, and he said that God speaks once. Yes, he speaks twice, but man does not perceive it. And many a times we find ourselves at that place, that we are too busy that we cannot hear God. We are too busy that we cannot listen to God. Oh, there are so many things that we are struggling and fighting with until we miss the voice of God. But our miracle begins by, first of all, that which we hear. Because that is what will drop into our heart, and out of the abundance of the heart, that is what we will bubble out, and ultimately, that is what we will see. There's so many blessings that God will desire to bless us with, and my prayer is that let us not miss out, because we have missed it. Divine connection between the ear, the mouth, and the eyes. I want to pray for all of us. And even as I pray, wherever you are, from the different places that you are watching us from, I know that as I have spoken, Jesus said that the words that are and they are life. These are words that do not respect distance. Wherever you are, you could be here in Kenya, you could be in Uganda, you could be in Tanzania, you could even be in America. But wherever you are, you could be here in Nairobi or Busia, you could be here or Bungoma, Lugari. From, let me tell you, this particular message and this prayer that you're going to make this morning, they are enough to make, give us a divine turnaround. And has been stubborn. The way the blind man received sight. Let me pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, indeed you are a good God. You are encouraging, you are protecting. You have lost any battle. You are the Lord of hosts. You are the King of kings. You are the wonderful counselor. You are the Prince of peace. And believe. Amen and amen. God bless you.